Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I am going to talk about the respiratory system. I will talk about the parts of the respiratory system. I will talk about the basic anatomical features of each part. And then I will talk about the functions and the diseases related to the system. The respiratory system has another name. It's called oxygen delivery system because it delivers oxygen to the body. It starts at the nose, then the pharynx, then the larynx, then the trachea. And the trachea divides into two main bronchi or bronchi, which end in the lungs, and finally the diaphragm, which is the main muscle of inspiration. Regarding the main function of the respiratory system, the main function is to deliver oxygen to the blood to supply the organs of the body. When we breathe, we inhale oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide. And the exchange of gases occur in the alveoli. So the exchange of gases occurs in the alveoli. Regarding breathing, we breathe about 16 times per minute. The breathing consists of two phases. The first phase is inspiration, taking in oxygen. And the second phase is expiration, getting rid of carbon dioxide. During inspiration, the diaphragm contracts, drawing it down, and during expiration the diaphragm relaxes, drawing it up. Start with the nose. The basic features of the nose: this is the nasal cavity, one nasal cavity, another nasal cavity, and this is the septum between the two cavities. So the nose is divided into two cavities by the nasal septum. Each cavity is lined with mucous membrane. This mucous membrane is rich in blood vessels and glands. And I will talk about the function of this feature later on. The lateral wall of the nasal cavity, this is the lateral wall of the nasal cavity, shows three elevations called the nasal conchae. The nasal conchae are three to increase the surface area of the nose. Superior, we don't see the superior. This is the middle concha and this is the inferior concha. And the lateral wall of the nasal cavity contains the openings of the paranasal sinuses. So the nasal cavity is divided into two cavities. The nose is divided into two cavities by the nasal septum. Each cavity is lined with mucous membrane, rich in blood vessels and glands. The lateral wall shows three elevations called the nasal conchae to increase the surface area. Okay, and the lateral wall contains the openings of the paranasal sinuses. This is the lateral wall of the nasal cavity. And the lateral wall of the nasal cavity shows three conchae: superior concha, middle concha, and the inferior concha. And the function of these conchae is to increase the surface area. Regarding the paranasal sinuses, paranasal sinuses are four, and they are spaces filled with air. This is the first one in the frontal bone. It's called the frontal sinus. The second one in the ethmoid bone. It's called the ethmoidal sinuses because we have three ethmoidal sinuses. The third one in the maxilla, maxillary air sinus, and the fourth one in the sphenoid bone is sphenoid air sinus. So the four nasal sinuses, frontal, sphenoidal, maxillary, and sphenoid. What are the functions of the nasal sinuses? What are the functions of the air-filled spaces in the skull? The first function is to decrease the weight of the skull. Second one, to make the voice resonant. To increase the surface area for the air and the air conditioning for the head and absorb shocks in face trauma. So these are the functions of the paranasal sinuses. So in general, what are the functions of the nose? In general, what are the functions of the nose? The first function is olfaction, a smell. We smell by our nose, okay? Second function is respiration, okay? Third one, the blood vessels in the mucous membrane warm the air. How about the glands? The gland secretions humidify the air. How about the air? The air in the nose, the hair in the nose filter the air. So the functions of the nose: olfaction, respiration, the blood vessels warm the air, the gland secretions humidify the air, and the hair is for filtration of the air. Then we'll talk about the pharynx. This is the pharynx. The pharynx is a muscular tube. This muscular tube is about 5 inches long. It begins at the base of the skull, okay, till C6, the sixth cervical vertebra. So the pharynx extends from the base of the skull till C6. The pharynx is divided into three parts. The part behind the nasal cavity, this part, is called the nasopharynx. So nasopharynx behind the nose. The second part behind the oral cavity, this part, is called the oropharynx. And the third part behind the larynx is called the laryngopharynx. So the three divisions of the pharynx: nasopharynx behind the nose, oropharynx behind the oral cavity, and the laryngopharynx behind the larynx. Let us see the main features in each one. Regarding the nasopharynx, this is the nasopharynx. The nasopharynx contains two main features. The first one is the opening of the auditory tube or eustachian tube. The second one is collection of lymphoid tissue at the roof. It's called the adenoid or pharyngeal tonsil. So the two features in the nasopharynx: the opening of the auditory tube or eustachian tube, and the adenoid or pharyngeal tonsil. Regarding the oropharynx, this is the oropharynx. It contains the palatine tonsil. This is the palatine tonsil. Okay? And the laryngopharynx, this is the laryngopharynx. The laryngopharynx continues as the esophagus. Then regarding the larynx, this is the larynx. This is the larynx, okay, the larynx here. The larynx is formed of 9 cartilages. The three prominent ones are: this is the first one, thyroid cartilage. This is the second one, coracoid cartilage. And this is the third one, epiglottis. Okay, so the larynx is formed of 9 cartilages. The three prominent ones are thyroid cartilage, coracoid cartilage, and the epiglottis. And the epiglottis prevents the food from entering the trachea. And the larynx contains the vocal cords. These are the vocal cords and the vocal cords for sound production. So what are the functions of the larynx? The functions of the larynx, number one, respiration. It is part of the respiratory system. Second one, phonation, sound production. Third one, protection by epiglottis. The epiglottis prevents food from entering into the trachea. And another protection by cough reflex. So cough reflex prevents water or food from entering the trachea. Then the trachea and the bronchial tubes or bronchial tree. Regarding the trachea, this is the trachea, this is the front, and this is the back. So the trachea is formed of incomplete larynx to keep the trachea open. So why the larynx of the trachea are incomplete? To keep the trachea open. The trachea splits into two primary bronchi or two primary bronchi, right bronchus and left bronchus. Each primary bronchus branches and rebranches into bronchioles, and the bronchioles terminate in the alveoli. So trachea, primary bronchi, bronchioles, and alveoli. Regarding the differences between the right bronchus and the left bronchus, right main bronchus and left main bronchus, three main differences. The first difference is the length. The right bronchus is shorter, it is about 1 inch long. The left bronchus is longer, about 2 inches long. Regarding the right bronchus is wider, the left bronchus is narrower. The right bronchus is in line with the trachea, so it is almost vertical. Okay, straight. So the right bronchus is straight or vertical in line with the trachea. The left bronchus is oblique. There is an angle with the trachea. So what is the clinical significance of being wider and being straight? Any foreign body, any inhaled foreign body, will enter the right bronchus and then the right lung. So why inhaled foreign body enter the right bronchus? Because it is wider than the left, and also because it is in line with the trachea, it is straight. Regarding the lungs, each lung is surrounded by a serous membrane. This serous membrane is called the pleura. So each lung is surrounded by a membrane called pleura. Okay. And each lung is conical in shape. It's conical in shape, has apex and base. Apex and base. This is the right lung and this is the left lung. And the medial surface of each lung has hilum or root for entry of the bronchi and the blood vessels. The right lung, this is the right lung. The right lung has two fissures and three lobes. The left lung has only one fissure, okay, and two lobes. So the right lung is formed of three lobes. The left lung is formed of two lobes. The right lung has two fissures. The left lung has only one fissure. The lung is divided into segments. The right lung is divided into 10 segments. The left lung is usually divided into 8 segments. It may be divided into 10, it may be divided into 9, but it is usually divided into 8, and we'll discuss this with the anatomy of the lung. So what are the differences between the right lung and the left lung? The right lung is shorter than the left lung. Why? Because the right lung is located above the liver. The liver is pushing the lung upward. So the right lung is shorter than the left because the right lung is related to the liver. The right lung is wider than the left lung because the left lung is compressed by the heart. The right lung is formed of 3 lobes. The left lung is formed of 2 lobes. The right lung has 2 fissures. The left lung has only 1 fissure. And the right lung is usually divided into 10 segments. The left lung is usually divided into 8 segments. This is an X-ray of the chest. The black shadow is the shadow of the air inside the lung. The white shadow is the shadow of the soft tissue. So this is the shadow of the heart, okay? And this is the shadow of the diaphragm. Then regarding diseases of the lung, bronchial asthma, bronchitis, pneumonia, cystic fibrosis, and lung cancer. So what is bronchial asthma? Bronchial asthma is narrowing of the bronchial tubes. The narrowing of the bronchial tubes is allergic disease. This allergic disease is triggered by irritants such as fumes, dust, drugs, and cigarette smoke. It causes difficulty in breathing. Then, bronchitis. Bronchitis is inflammation of the bronchial tubes. About pneumonia? Pneumonia is inflammation of the lung alveoli. How about cystic fibrosis? Cystic fibrosis is genetic disease. This genetic disease causes excessive mucus production, obstructing the airway. So cystic fibrosis, genetic disease, causing excessive mucus production, which obstruct the airway, leading to cyst formation. So bronchitis is inflammation of the bronchial tubes. Pneumonia is inflammation of the lung alveoli. Cystic fibrosis is genetic disease. How about lung cancer? This is normal lung. This is lung cancer. Lung cancer is the most common cancer among male smokers. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.